opposition leaders are meeting at the Constitution Club. This is after Congress leader Rahul Gandhi invited them for a breakfast meeting this morning to discuss the opposition strategy for the monsoon session at a time when Parliament is seeing a deadlock. Remember, everyday opposition members have been raising slogans and protesting and demanding a probe into the Pegasus spyware scandal, something the government has dismissed again and again and even called it a non-issue. However, the opposition then today, after Parliament has been disrupted for over 2 weeks now, has called for this meeting. Rahul Gandhi inviting opposition parties, 18 opposition parties for this meeting. Let's go across to Sunil Prabhu for more. And Sunil, tell us what's happening. We can see visuals of Mallikarjun Kharge. He's actually addressing all the leaders.
That's right. They are now trying to evolve a strategy, a way forward, an innovative way, as they say, of trying to send that message loud and clear to the people of India about the fact that the government on their part is not ready for a discussion. Some opposition MPs are planning to even cycle from here to Parliament to talk about the rising prices. But I think the main and most important issue for which they want the government to come forward is on the issue of the snooping and the Pegasus software. Did India buy the Pegasus software? And if so, what is the plan? Why was it used against individuals and constitutional authorities who are not related to terrorism and national security? These are the mute questions that are being asked. And I think ultimately the Supreme Court, which is going to hear this matter, the opposition parties will wait till a decision is taken in this regard from there. But either way, politically, they want to continue to put the pressure on the government and say that the onus of running parliament is on them. There's a talk of a mock parliament. There are various other ways to do it. It seems likely that they will walk, cycle, send that message of camaraderie as they go to parliament to continue to raise what they believe are people's issues. Because just apart from the snooping, price rise, the handling of the COVID, there are a host of other issues which they feel the government must come clean on, just as it said on the floor of the House through a written question that there are no oxygen-related deaths. So it's in that context that accountability is still being demanded by the opposition. The government, of course, has been dialing up but not being able to reach out and find a resolution on how they want to take up this matter of phone snooping.
Right, Sunil, have there been any attempts really to, you know, reach out in a sense to the opposition? Because that's what we see that usually happens when the parliament is deadlocked in this manner. You know, ministers come across and try to meet with opposition leaders. However, we do know that, you know, information has been released about how much this is costing the exchequer over the weekend. That data was released saying that it's costed 133 crores to the exchequer, all these wasted hours in parliament. Very little business getting done, a few odd bills here and there have been passed. And that is also created a controversy because opposition has said there's been no discussion. How can you just pass these bills in this manner?
That's right. It's a no-brainer, actually, Gargi, when you say 133 crores. We all know that every minute of parliament costs nearly 2.5 lakhs of rupees. The onus of running parliament, who convenes parliament? It's the government. The president summons it on the cabinet's recommendation. And it is for the cabinet and the government to allow parliament to function, to ensure that they are able to get ahead with government business, not pass legislation in the manner it has done within minutes without any proper discussion and amidst the din. Having said that, yes, there is been some reaching out by the Parliamentary Affairs Minister as well as by the others.
Foundation of unity. And then between the within the foundation of unity, we can have a few discussions and few arguments where we disagree with each other. But I think it is important that now we start to come up with the principles of the foundation of this unity. Finally, Kharge ji mentioned something which is, I don't know if many of you would like to do it or not, and it's completely up to you. I thought that as far as the fuel price is concerned, the people of India are struggling. They are struggling with the amount of money they have to pay for their cars. So I thought symbolically, if we go from here to Parliament on cycles, it could have an interesting impact. It would have a media impact as well, and people would see that the opposition feels the pain of the fuel prices. That's anybody who, of course, many people won't be able to do it. They'll be uncomfortable, but only people who are comfortable riding a cycle. So thank you very much again.
All right, so there Rahul Gandhi, who has convened this meeting of opposition leaders, opposition members in at the Constitution Club. They're saying that, you know, one of the ways that they can draw attention to this issue of the price rise, the fuel price rise, is by cycling to Parliament. Well, let's go back to Sunil. So, Sunil, we heard Rahul Gandhi saying that those members who may, everybody won't be able to do it, but those who want to can cycle to Parliament, you know, really to bring home that emphasis on the fact that rising fuel prices is something the opposition is very concerned about.
That's right. And as we can see, they're saying roll back fuel gas, cooking oil, loot. 2014 LPG was 410 rupees. In 2014, diesel was 55 rupees. And it's in that backdrop that they continue to protest. I think symbolic way, but that's the procedure now that parliamentarians are getting ready to make their presence felt. Over 100 members of parliament from Constitution Club will be coming here. From Constitution Club, marching and cycling to Parliament House to send that message that this is something that they want to talk about. When they say there are there, as you can say, this, you know, in 2014 was 71 rupees. Today we are all talking about three figures, 100 and odd, and it's in that context that this entire situation has erupted. The reason why we have seen parliament and the standoff taking place between the opposition and the government, really no business being transacted. The Youth Congress here, led by Mr. Srinivas and the other volunteers, just getting ready those cycles to send that message to most political parties. This is more of a visual opportunity to send that message loud and clear to do it.
All right, so that meeting of opposition parties taking place this morning at the Constitution Club, and now members may be cycling, some of them will be cycling to Parliament to emphasize the rising fuel prices.